Hello everyone and welcome to my new 5 Minutes Friday. In this one we will learn how to make 3D images and upload it to your Facebook. These are pretty popular these days. We'll learn how to make it with Cinema 4D and Corona Render, and we don't have much time, so let's get started. Okay, so here we are inside of Cinema 4D, and this is a free scene. You can take it from my Patreon page. I will link it down below the YouTube video, so you can play with it, you can use it. What can we do here is just make a quick preview of a render, so we can see exactly what is going on and what we will do to make this image ready for Facebook 3D. We have pretty nice depth of field right here. One of the main things you need to go to Corona multipass, and I will just delete this for now, and you will need to enable this right here and find under the geometry the Z depth. So this one you will drag and drop right here, so you get these values. So a minimum Z is what will be white in our Z depth or depth image, and this other Z will be black ones. I like to work with objects instead of this just value, so you will pick the closest or the object that is in focus. So you want to pick, for example, this polygon here, which represent our leaves, and for the black one I will use this one. Okay, so what does it do? We'll go ahead and render once again. Okay, we have enough to see what we got here. So you can see this is the beauty of our image, and inside of here in this panel we have in drop menu Z depth, and we click on that. We can see that everything that is near to the camera is white, and everything that is far away from it is gray. So as we don't have much time, I will just jump to the next step, which is Photoshop and uploading to Facebook. So let's go there. Okay, so we are inside of Photoshop now. So the next thing you need to take care of is the naming. We named our image main, so the thing you need to take care of is to put an underline there after the name and put depth. In this way Facebook will recognize that this need to be 3D image. So we'll just jump right here, and what works not that well inside of 3D recognition of the Facebook is a great contrast. So if you get something like this, let's say something like this, these edges will be problematic and you will get all sorts of artifacts. So what you want to do is just try and make your image gray and black, and in that way you will get really nice results. So let's go ahead, merge this, save this, and let's go jump into the Facebook and upload this, and let's see our result. Okay, so what you need to do now is drag and drop both of your pictures right here, and automatically the Facebook will recognize this as a creating a 3D photo, and you just wait a bit, and in a minute it will do its magic and you will have interesting 3D effect. There are still some artifacts around, but they are not that noticeable, and if you look it on the mobile phone it will be even more interesting you can polish this a little bit inside the Photoshop Fit level so you don't get any artifact. This was a quick one, but you got the point. And if you like this video, you can check my Patreon page. I have put it inside here. You can hit like and subscribe if you want more of this free YouTube videos on Corona topic or Octane render. And see you guys next time.